start this vlog.
Hi.
Hey.
Welcome to the vlog. My camera's going to die, so we'll just put us in hiding again. Oh.
Hi.
This will be the quickest intro you've ever seen.
Because the camera's about to die.
Okay, about 2 seconds.
But watch Abby's vlog, it's going to be amazing.
Yeah, what have we got? Oh yeah, do we get events this week?
What do you have? Do you have the Kylie one?
Got the Kylie Jenner event.
I'm off to Paris, wee wee.
I know, I'm so gutted I'm missing that. That'll be a busy girl that day.
Yeah.
Giggle, giggle, giggle.
Look at me on a Monday, guys.
I know, how different are we? Like,
look at Megan and then look at me. Oh, that's
true. We never match.
No, we never match.
No, never ever. Her name, the Vega, and honestly, guys, they've obviously got a lot of money in here because the cost of this,
the heating.
Through the roof.
We're in a Turkish bath up here, it's fucking roasting.
Sweating, I've got a fur, like a woolly coat on. Look at me. Look at my face.
This outfit is heating me up and all.
It's doing wonders. And then the milkiest coffee in the world.
Yeah.
But yeah, welcome to the vlog.
Welcome in the vlog.
Hi guys, how are we all? I feel like I've not done like a video, well I haven't done a video in ages, duh. How are we all? Hope everyone is doing well. Today, it has been I haven't stepped over the door. Physically, nothing. Not even opened the door, actually. I've had an admin day today. I've not come out my jammies. And so much so I put my fake tan on this morning, which is quite unusual, but I just thought, you know what, I'm not leaving the house today, I'm going to put my tan on today, I'm going to wash my hair tonight, I'm going to wash my tan off tonight, so tomorrow I'm organised. So yeah, so it's just me and my dad in at the moment, and my wee dad is on night shift at the moment, so I am going to make my dinner earlier. So my dad is currently on night shift, and my mum hates my mum's cooking, right, so I am making dinner a little bit earlier and I'm going to set my dinner aside, but I'm really making this so that my dad can have his dinner before he goes to work because I'm a good daughter like that. So of course, because we're having dinner, you know what I'm about to say? HelloFresh. If you haven't used HelloFresh and you're wanting to use HelloFresh, I would say this is the time because I have an amazing offer, and I just think if you're going to try something and you're unsure if you're going to like it or not, I always say you're better to do it, like whether it be like buying something on sale or buying something on an offer. And the good thing with HelloFresh, guys, is it's actually such a big saving. It's not like a wee bit of money off, it's honestly a really good saving. It's actually quite funny because my mum's neighbours both use HelloFresh, and always like that, can you get your discount code? But this is tonight's dinner here, which I'm really looking forward to because I actually am in the mood for like noodles or like kind of like Asian type of food, so I'm really looking forward to this. So it's stir fried honey sesame beef noodles with tender stem broccoli, carrots and ribbons. Now just a little point out, you get loads of different options here. So this one's called family, so you get family, you get rapid, you get calorie smart, you get like vegetarian, pescatarian, you get like carb friendly. You get loads of different options. You can select for how many people that you want. You can select for how many nights you want. This obviously alternates the price. But honestly, I find it so useful. I also find that you will save so much money. You will not be buying stuff. You don't need to buy anything in. What you get from HelloFresh is physically all you need, apart from maybe a bit of salt and pepper, but we've all got salt and pepper. So here you have all your ingredients here, and then it's always 6 instructions. So even if you're someone who is not very confident in cooking, I actually think in a way HelloFresh is like a mix of things. It will teach you how to cook. Like there's so many things now that I know how to make. Like you can make like this teriyaki sauce that I've had quite a few times, and like you add ketchups, and it obviously gives you all the ingredients. But if I ever wanted to remake it, just say a night I'm not having HelloFresh, then it's like I now know how to make certain stuff. Same with like, I love the Cajun sea bass that you sometimes get on HelloFresh. I've made that so many times as well because I've learned how to make it. So you do learn as you go, which I also think is really, really good. So what I'll do is I'll pop up my code and everything here, but you can click on the link. It will be at the very, very top of my description box. And that gets you 60% off your first box, which is way over half price, which is amazing saving. And then you also with that get 25% off your next 2 months. So again, if you're going to be getting this continuously, then you're going to have savings as well continuously. So I will make sure that link is at the top of my description box for you guys, just in case you want to check it out. And like I said, I honestly do think you save money. Oh, look at this. Look at this. It's So we think, we as a family think, you save money, it is way better. Also, if you're someone who doesn't have a lot of time, I honestly really recommend it because you can get the rapid meals and they literally take 10-15 minutes max. And also...
Yeah, I'm trying to tell everyone about HelloFresh.
Okay. See, the quality of the stuff, like you get the best vegetables, and also what I have noticed is everything stays really fresh. Like I've noticed recently when I'm going to supermarkets and I'm buying some fruit and vegetables, they're going off in like 1 or 2 days. Whereas literally is what we always say, my house mum's like, I can't believe that stuff's still in great condition. So they use the best quality products, and honestly, the meals are chef's kiss. And just to clarify, if you're ever picking your meals and you see Cajun sea bass, it usually comes with mash. Run and get it. It's probably the best meal I've ever had at a HelloFresh. I love it. I actually love it. So yeah, that's going to cook dinner, and I'm going to keep mine aside, but my dad's going to have his because I'm some daughter. I'm doing this for my dad before he goes night shift, so... Guys, I got my hair done today. Got it, like, I was trying to keep my root, to be fair, so it's not much different, but it's just more soft blend. And then I got my colour done, my blonde, because it was looking a bit yellow. But I just got a wine stop to try. I've been dying to do these. I always see, is anyone else's TikTok always just covered in people eating wine stop? It's like 1 a.m, I'm like, why do I want chicken tenders or chicken nuggets? So we'll see. So I got some of these. And then I've got the burger thing to try. Wow, saucy. And some fries. Hey, Coco Loco. But the other guys have not given me a sauce. Honestly, it drives me scatty when places don't give sauce, because I'm just like, how is that difficult? How is it difficult to put sauce in a bag?
I need help. Barbecue.
Give me a barbecue and there's like any meal. Both of me. The chips are quite nice to be fair, guys. I'm spicy there.
Too spicy for me.
The chips are super spicy. So it's like buffalo ranch chips. I really wanted the ranch dip. They've also done the dirty. But. So there's them. Then we have a chicken burger. Oh, it's got mango habanero sauce, I think it's meant to be. We'll give this a try. Over the moon. I think I've made a schoolboy error with this dinner tonight. I think I've bopped everybody. Right, we'll just need to go with the Pyrenees. I got the lemon pepper. Tenders. See what these are like. Taste some McDonald's selects. Well, that was disappointing. I don't think it's as good as the American one makes out to be. Maybe the American one's better, but... Yeah, it's pretty disappointing. Don't get it, guys.
Morning, everyone. How are we? Oh, tired this morning, but guys, what a sleep I got last night. So I'd been out on Saturday. I was out Friday actually for the Aquarius charity ball, And then I was out Saturday, and Saturday I took it too far. Getting quite good at that recently. Honestly, guys, the like now when you're drunk, usually when I'm drunk, I get a good sleep. I was like so uncomfortable in bed. I felt so sick. I was being sick. It was just hell. Excuse the state of me, by the way. So, my coffee's ready. So, last night I was trying to fight the sleep. I was like, don't go to sleep too early because I wanted to try and sleep the whole way through. And then I went to bed I fell asleep about 9:30. Guys, what a sleep I got. I actually woke up like this in the exact same position. Someone's coming down the stairs.
Hi, Dad.
I don't know if you should have seen that. I couldn't tell if it was in camera or not. My dad's just came down and gave me money. That sounds like random. I think he thinks like I'm still wee. Like my dad used to do it when I was in school. Maybe give me like a tenner or something. He's the nicest man in the world. But anyway, I'm making a coffee this morning. But I forgot that I need to go to the shop. I've not done a food shop. I've actually not went to a supermarket in months. So I need to use some honey, but I actually use what out.
There you go. I know it's wet, but gotta do the toilet.
So I need to go to the shops. I'm going to do that today anyway. But I had this the other day and I just put honey. I put it, so I did this before and it stuck to the straw and it was like really clumpy when I was drinking it. But the other day I put it straight in with a hot coffee. And before I put my milk in and just mix that. And I think the heat from the hot coffee helps the honey mix rather than being pure thick. And then we've got our milk. I honestly don't think anyone can make it better than I do.
Starting a Christmas video, so I'm going to film Christmas Eve, Christmas Day and Boxing Day. You going to say hi to the vlog?
Hi there.
You know, I've not vlogged in so long, I've not been good on YouTube.
Are you really?
Oh, no.
You're slacking?
No, I have. I've just been too busy with life, it's just too much. But anyway, here we are. So we're out for a family dinner, really funny guys, we're actually for my brother's birthday. And my brother's not came.
Thank you.
We're just laughing, we came out for my son's birthday. Oh. He never came.
And he's not came.
Well, I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. So that's my brother's chair. And he's not at it.
And that's his bread, he would not be having a starter.
But yeah, we're going to Malaga tapas. I've actually got a few. We've been here before. We came with family, didn't we?
Aye, fantastic.
We came with family before. It was lovely.
Beautiful.
That's why we came back, because my brother liked it and he doesn't really like loads of places, but
there you go.
Never came. But anyway, I'm very hungover. I was out last night, took it too far. What time did I start in the day, Dad?
They started in 1:10.
Never in the afternoon, not at night, in the afternoon. But anyway, time to eat some carbs.
You just get the hands in, Abby. Just the hands.
Oh no!
Right, conversation opener.
Blind feet.
Right, I've got a joke.
Can I get a hat?
Yes. I don't want a blue hat.
Goes in the t-shirt.
Simon walks into a bar. The barman says, sorry, we don't serve food.
Simon, food.
Got it. Got it.
We're going to sing a chorus because you only get a short bit of the you only get a short bit of the camera, the thing with the music in it. We're home, guys. It's time to wrap some Christmas presents. I'd actually say this is probably the first year I've had less people to buy for this year. I mean, not complaining. Excuse the mess over there. Yeah, not complaining that I've got, I feel like I bought other gift wrap the other day. What did I do with that? Tesco bag. You go find it. But yeah, this year I've not had as many people to buy for, and I wasn't going tonto this year. Usually I go wild at Christmas, but I just wasn't doing it this year. I have way too much on. And yeah, I just have to be a bit more sensible. Don't a baby girl. Sheesh. I mean, I wasn't sensible when I bought your presents. I wasn't sensible. When I bought your presents, no. You just love kissing me. Oh, you're not kissing you. Made my Christmas Day dessert. I'll show you. I did a wee TikTok. Pop it up there for you. Might need to mute the music. But it's currently my brother's bar out the back because the fridge is full and it has to be cold. It's ice cold in there, so. Stop it, cheeky girl. But yeah, so I'm going to wrap my presents. I'm going to put on a Christmas movie as we do it. It's weird, I don't feel very Christmassy this year. I'm usually quite a Christmas kid. I think, you know, it's my first year without doing my usual routine, which is like, usually I'm cooking all day on Christmas Eve, and obviously usually I would have been in the house, and then like making desserts, because usually I'd be making desserts for loads of people, whereas this year I'm just making dessert for the four of us. So it didn't take me that long. Like after I did it, I was like, I think I forgot to do something, but it's just because I'm used to making like 3 or 4 different desserts. So obviously I'm not doing that this year. So yeah, it's a weird Christmas Eve for me, but I'm going away very soon on holiday. Go away in 3 days. I've not even packed a case or tried on an outfit. That'll be fun. But hey-ho. Story of my life. I didn't film Vlogmas this year, obviously, as you guys know, because you haven't watched it. But I just genuinely didn't have the time. There was just genuinely so much on, and Bly has really become a proper full-time job, which is quite hard. I'm hoping getting into the new year we may be able to like either take on someone to help, or maybe need to manage it better. But it's been quite chaotic, that on top of just my normal job. It's just a lot, so I've just not had the time. I didn't want to do a half-hour video, so I thought I would just film like Christmas Eve, Christmas Day, Boxing Day, and then I go on holiday on the 27th, and I'll vlog like a little bit about being on holiday, and then when I come back from my holiday, I've got the premiere of the show coming out, so there'll be loads of that, so I'll vlog like back to vlogging in the new year. That's my New Year's resolution this year, is to be consistent on YouTube, because it's actually, whenever I get asked what's my favourite social media platform, it's YouTube. It just seems to be the one that I fall away from the most. But yeah, happy Christmas Eve, everyone. I hope everyone's having a lovely Christmas Eve with your family. I know Christmas is a very difficult time for everyone, so if it is a little bit of a difficult time, then I hope you're okay. And I cannot wait for the new year, as much as I know Christmas hasn't even been yet. But yeah, sorry, my camera died. Christmas is usually like my favourite day ever. But I'm hoping... I think this year for me has just been a right opposite, it's been a bit of a what the fuck year. And I actually hope next year I'm just in like my own wee house again, new traditions. I think as well, see, because this year I've not put up any decorations. Like obviously, usually at my decoration day is a full event. It's a Chinese, it's movies on. My mum and dad come up, they used to help me do all my decorations. It used to be a full event. So obviously I've not done that this year because I've just let mum and dad do their own routine, obviously. So I don't know if that's also why I've kind of... I don't feel like it's Christmas, but yeah, hopefully next year I'm in like my own wee home, put all my decorations up because I fucking love my Christmas tree. My Christmas tree will forever be with me. That will not be a tree that ever gets binned. I want to have that Christmas tree when I get kids, my wee family, and I'll be like, I bought that Christmas tree and it was expensive and it was the best, and all my wee baubles and all that. So yeah, let's wrap some Christmas presents and get in the Christmas spirit. What movie did I want?
Has Santa been for you? Is Santa?
I am. Hi, darling.
Say hi, Santa.
Hi, oh, no.
Yay, right, we're going. Yay. Come on. Yay. Let's see if Santa's been. Come on, then. Come on, then. You go, Bear. Go there. Go down, that's not yours. Santa's done his there for you. Come on, Mia. Oh. Right, Mia, I need you to get down the stairs. Come on. Come on, big boy. Yeah.
Papa.
Shut up.
Yeah.
Is that a mean? Right, come on.
Join, boy.
Hurried me all morning now. They're not coming.
What's in here?
Is that for you?
Nope. That's not yours.
Who's Santa been, my boy? What is taking them so long? Dad, hi. Paul!
Now!
Hurry up! I want to see my boys with Santa. She always does that, puts a wee pod in your top. I love you! Santa loves you!
Touching Nana's boobies.
Big boy's wagging his tail.
I'm doing my chest.
Big boy's wagging his tail.
Oh no!
Hey, mad in the honours of the door?
Yeah, it is.
Hey, Santa's been! Yay! Woohoo!
And the birthday fairy for Paul.
Oh! Birthday fairy for Paul.
Abby?
Me, I'm over here.
Your tea's there.
A stunning cup Paul. Of tea.
Oh, cheers.
I need to divvy mine out, everybody's.
What about the other two? Do the same?
Aye.
I think so, I'm in. Yay, look.
Yeah, look.
Hi, guys. I'm not actually got ready yet for Christmas Day. I've done it quite back to front this year. But, yeah, I got absolutely spoiled work. Hi, Bear. Show me my boy. Oh, wee ginger man got spoiled rotten. You got loads of new toys and a new ball. As you can see, I don't know if you can see, can you? All the new toys. But I got, so I've always wanted one of these nomination bracelets. And Amy's boyfriend Chris at the Bly Exceed event got me, Amy and Kirsten a B. And I was like, oh my god, I don't have a bracelet. And I gave mum and dad the charm because I said, I'm going to buy myself a bracelet. And I honestly just forgot. And then when I opened it, I was like, oh my god. So what my mum and dad have done is I'll take it off. It's too big, so I'm going to go get it made small tomorrow. But they, can you see that? They did a B-L-Y. And then they've got a pink heart and a blue heart for Bear and Coco. How nice is that? And then my mum and dad said they didn't know if I wanted silver or gold. So they've bought the gold. But there's no charms on it, so tomorrow we'll go up and get that made smaller. I'm sorry. No, you're fine. But how nice is that? So I just texted Amy's boyfriend there because I was like, finally I've got the B on. And then I've got... How comfy do they look? I think they look better than the UGG ones, by the way.
They're gorgeous.
I'm going to put them on. They're Jack Wills, but they look so comfy.
Excuse me, Tim.
And then it's not a Christmas... If I don't get a Kennedy's gift set, best shampoo and conditioner, I love it. See, if you're like me who's got like really thick hair, that's really good, and you also get like a, well, you get different ones for different things. So this one's anti-hair fortifying blowout, so it's like a blow drying serum, and this one in your shampoo and conditioner. I got that, I got, of course, the good old Hendrix, my gin. I don't know if my mum and dad have forgot. I said that. I said, did you know you've bought me three then? My dad was like, I don't know, we bought you three. But anyway,
if you know, one thing I always take pride in is the fact that I always get told I smell good. And I've got a thing about smells. I always think I stink. I know that sounds chaotic, but like any of my friends, they'll laugh at this. I always see them on it. I'm like, do I smell? And I always go, give me a hug. And I do that at Moxa's. And then at Erin's 30th, I was beside my friend Courtney's boyfriend, Ross. And I was like, Ross, go and give me a hug and like tell me if I smell. And I was like, waving my arms. And he was like, you're a weirdo. I just have a pure fear of it. And my scent is YSL Libra. But it used to be my scent when I went on nights out, and then now I use it every single day, so I'm going through the bottle quite quickly, which isn't good. But my dad got me the intense one, and then I said the other day, he's like, do you wear? And I said, oh, just a normal one. So I think that's how he said when he bought me the normal as well. He could have just left it. And then they got me this gift set, so I got like a wee travel one, another big bottle, and then look at that lipstick. That looks like my perfect shade, by the way. So I'm buzzing, so that means I can take that out of my bag when I go to buy. I got two Dior lip oils, my favourite, they're different colours. This time I got 006, which is berry, and then the clear one. I got makeup from YSL. I got Hilarious, I was pure slagging my dad this morning. So my dad went out and bought me these two cups from Starbucks, but I already had that, and this was the first thing I opened this morning. And I said, is money tight this year? I would just rewrap presents that I've already got. My dad was like, I swear I never rewrapped it. I was like, okay, but no. More iced coffee cups from me. And then I got some pyjamas. And then my mum and dad and my brother were very, very kind this year and gave me a lot of money to go to Dubai with. So I'm really looking forward to that now. So yeah, it's been a lovely Christmas morning, and we're now just going to go have breakfast, and I'm going to get freshened up, and then possibly going to try and go quickly see AC before she has a mad mental Christmas day. But yeah, I hope you're all having a lovely Christmas morning, and yeah, love you guys lots, and me and my babies, we team forever. Our wee breakfast set up, we've got some bacon and tatty scones.
Oh,
croissant, stacks mine and wee piece, get your wee hat on. We're gonna have a wee mimosa. Mimosa time, Coco Loco. Get that big, thick, bad baby and lure back. It's Boxing Day, guys, and it's chaos in here. Haven't packed a fucking thing for my holiday, and I go tomorrow, so that's fun. But hopefully, I mean, mum and dad are actually going to help. I need a quick pee. But I went for our lunch today with my friends. We always do that. Usually we go out. Hold on. Yeah, I would rather put pins in my eyes because see the hangovers I've been getting. I don't know if it's because I've been going out like sometimes 2-3 days in a row and drinking. But my hangovers recently have not been fun. Really bad. But left the girls in the pub when I went to my family's house for a little bit, picked mum and dad up, and then we're now home, and we're going to quickly have some leftover Christmas dinner. Dad wants to finish it, and usually I would like have it the 26th, 27th, but obviously I'm not here tomorrow, so I'm going to just have it tonight. I'm not actually that hungry, but I can force it the devil down. I'll never say no to a Christmas dinner. So going to do that, and then it's a group effort, my mum and dad, and we're going to pack. To be fair, I'm kind of not like over fussing with this holiday because this is honestly my first holiday in like, well, since the last time I went to Dubai, and that was last, not this year, the year before, and that was a holiday. But this trip's very much needed, and I feel like as well, like I've probably been dropping hints recently, and you're probably all like going to just hurry up and say it, but obviously the show's coming out very soon. It's coming out on the 8th, and I think if you watch a show and you watch me on YouTube, I think it'll all make sense this year with the way I've been. And I think this holidays came at a time when I do need it, and I'm kind of looking forward to not being here when the bells go off. I think I'll really find it hard this year. Like yesterday, I kind of stopped vlogging, as you could probably tell, and I found really Christmas Day hard, quite hard yesterday. And today, I found it quite hard. So I think it's going to be quite good that I'm going to be away for the bells, and I'm going to be with all my, well, not all my friends, but a lot, some of my friends that live in Dubai. So I think that'll be good. And then when I come back, it's all go with the show, which will be part of a vlog. That'll be the first vlog of 2024. Mad. So yeah, so mum and dad are going to help me pack. Don't know what the point actually was. Mum and dad are going to help me quit the pack. Well, that was it. Yeah, so I've really only got, we've got plans on like New Year's Eve. We're going to like the Emirates Club, I think it is. Come in. That's like a big, what? Oh, I didn't know it was ready, but I'm coming. That's like a big day. It's like the fancy night. Is my phone down the stair? Is my phone down there? Right. That's like a fancy night. Then the only thing I've asked to go to is Sushi Samba. Adam's booking that there, so that's like a fancy night. Then we've got a brunch, which is a fancy night, and then we've got everything else. We're quite chill, so I don't need loads, and I'm not going to take hours of photos either. Like, it's not one of those trips for me, so hopefully it won't take as long to pack. Ready for round two of Christmas dinner, Ginger Man? I'm going to miss you. Yeah. I'm going to miss you, big boy. Toy from Santa? Did Santa get you that? See, Santa got me new toys. Did Santa get you new toys? Did he? Oh. Hi guys, how are we all? This video's a bit all over the joint. It was meant to be just a vlog, but I just decided to put like Christmas Eve, Christmas Day, Boxing Day into this video. I know it's, we're now in 2024, but who cares? Who goddamn cares? This year is a year of doing what do you want?
What do you want?
Oh, who's crying? I don't think my big Ginger Man's crying. There's collar broke, so I need to do a super glue job on this bad boy. You're so goddamn handsome. I just love you, Ginger Man. I just love you. So yeah, I just thought, fuck it, we'll just put it all in one big video. This is going to be the first vlog. This is the first vlog of 2024 with a little, obviously, of end of 2023. How are we all? I hope everyone had a lovely Christmas and a lovely new year. I spent Christmas with my family. It was, I wonder if you could sit here. Not really, but it's probably easier for me to balance. I spent Christmas with my family, had a really chilled Christmas Eve, Christmas Day and Boxing Day, and then on the 27th I went to Dubai, obviously, which I've inserted little clips in of that, but it was so nice to get away
That's like, that was like my first holiday I've been on in years where it wasn't work related or anything like that. And like, I didn't have to do any jobs. I did one job, but I was there and I did it the last day. So yeah, it was a really nice wee trip. And I got to stay with my friend Lewis, which was fun. It's actually so funny staying with somebody who's not your boyfriend, like a boy. It was just hilarious, like, it's just different. I was at work, me and him just kept having cups of tea, like pure old people. I was like, look at the age of us, the days of what long gone of me and him, like, just our friend group being pure party people. And then me and him were sitting having a cup of tea watching the darts. And then I got home yesterday, so it is a busy weekend this weekend. We have, come on then. You can jump, you're at it. Up you come. Come on. Come on. Up you come. Come on. Ah, you're at it. Come on. Jump up. I'm not picking you up. You can jump. Go. Come on. Bear, come on. Jump up. Come on. Come on. Up. Come on. Up. 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 Come on. Bear, jump up. Oh, Jesus Christ. Who does this? So yeah, this is a hectic weekend. This weekend season 2 of the show is coming out on Monday. Today's Saturday. I've had rippling anxiety over over the show coming out this year. So will this go up before or after? So, I feel two ways about it. I feel nervous for those reasons, and I also feel like finally people might understand. Like, I think last year, it's no shock to anyone, I was very up and down like a yo-yo. I think my appearance, I didn't look the same. I know a lot of like close friends and family have said to me that I hadn't really looked like my usual self for quite a while, even prior to last year. It's obviously no like secret that I went through a breakup, which felt like it went on for a lifetime. And it is now that I'm in a new year that I am like done with, and I think as well with the show coming out and me speaking about it on the show, or like just even like maybe speaking about my feelings on the show, I remember when they told us it wasn't going to come out till January, I was really angry and I was really annoyed and I was like, what the fuck, like I want this out now, like just to get it over and done with. But now I'm in a new year and now I'm like in a new mindset. I do think it's maybe good that it's coming out now, because it's like letting that year be done. And in a way, this is like therapy, that it's going to come out. It'll be a hard watch for me, but it's going to come out and that's going to be it. Yeah, it's something that I'll never speak about again. It's also something that like will literally be erased from my life. And like, I will be starting everything again. Like, I can't wait till like I'm in a place this year where like I have my own home again. And like, for me, that'll probably be like, and like my first home, like that's the mindset I'm in this year, where I'm just like, I want that to be done. It has dragged on, it has literally lingered over me, it has been the biggest sadness I've probably ever went through on top of many other things. And I just think I'm at a place now where I think with the show coming out, you'll probably see how I was feeling, you'll see a very different side to me, and then that'll be that, if that makes sense. And then literally leave all that shite in 2023. And that will forever be the worst year of my life. However, I do think over time it will probably be the year that changed me as a person. Because I definitely don't feel like the same person. Like, I think I'm very much, I think I appreciate myself more now. And I think I appreciate that I'm actually a nice person and I have a good heart. And I think I'm just like, done. The shit in that year is finished. And there's so much to look forward to. Like, there's so much good stuff coming. There's so many big plans for Bly. I'm really focusing on my own career as well this year. Yeah, this is a bit of a rabble, but
I think my whole point is, I just hope with the show coming out, people will maybe understand why that 2023 for me was like, it wouldn't have been enjoyable to watch YouTube videos. I was probably up and down, because it's a lot easier to fake happiness and fake a smile via photo than it is to fake a YouTube video. Like, there's so much footage where I have filmed and I can't even watch it back because the sadness that I see is just wild. And I think it's just a part of my life I want to be over with and done with, and I'm looking forward to like being a new year. And I know that's so cheesy, people like, new year, new me, but like, it could not be more true for me that this year is literally just going to be the year when I forget about everything and I don't even want to think about it or speak about it. I just want to be done, and I think the show will do that for me probably this year. But yeah, so I'm going to just, sorry for the fucking sadness there, but today is Saturday, so I just went and got my usual blow dry. I'm back to my weekly blow dries. Love it for me. Want a hair change, guys, but I don't know what I want to do. I don't know if I want to do like, do I go no, I'm not going short. Who the fuck am I kidding? Going short. Maybe short hair. The only good thing about me is my fucking long hair. Anyway, my hair's been quite damaged this season since I've moved here to mom and dad's house. No disrespect to Alison, none at all, before she watches this and takes a pure personal attack. She doesn't like spending money on good shampoo and conditioner. I get it, she's got short hair, why would she? Oh my god, it's damaged my hair. My hairdresser was like, Abby mate, what are you using? I was like, I knew you were going to ask me that. So, I went and bought on Amazon, because you can buy like the big 1 litre one, like the big salon one. So it's this brand, is it Schwarzkopf? And it's the damage and repair one. So I bought the shampoo, the conditioner. I've also bought the sealed ends, which is good just for like sealing your, basically your ends. And then this mousse to try and get my hair to hold a curl, because recently my hair's just not been good. So what I'm thinking for the new year is, I don't want to overload on vlogs, but my YouTube is my priority. I had like an end of year meeting with Aquarius and I said my one priority this year is to be full time on YouTube again and really make that my effort. Big changes are happening with Bly. Bly has grown this year at a speed that I didn't think was even possible, and it's grew out with me, which is like bittersweet because one, I'm so grateful and so happy, but I'm also sad because I'm like, I feel like I do now need to take a step back from like the late, like the doing the orders and packaging and things like that, because it's just too much. Like the month of December, I was in that office till 1-2 in the morning a lot of nights, and I was there for 10 hours and I'm like lifting and loading parcels and like I'm doing heavy lifting that I should not be doing on my own, and it is just too much for one person. So we are expanding in that department, which then basically means it's going to be taking off my responsibility and I can now just fully focus on like my personal career as much as Bly is my career, but like influencing and YouTube and things is what like pays my salary. So this is where I really want to focus my time and my effort, and I'm really in my saving girl era. So I'm going to save loads this year. My aim is to either move into a house this year or buy a house this year and just have that as my main goal. So yeah, what was the point of that? So yeah, basically what I think I want to do is do like 2 vlogs a month, so like maybe like 1 every 2 weeks, and then in between that go back to my usual like hair care videos, makeup videos, skincare videos, what I eat in the week videos, all the fun stuff. So I'm actually going to, when that stuff arrives, I think it doesn't arrive till Monday, but I'm going to do like a proper hair care, like show you like the treatments that I use, show you like what I use in my hair when I do slick, shampoos, conditioners, styling treatments, all that type of stuff. So I'm going to do that next week and get that up. But yeah, today is, got my hair done, got a blow dry, and then later on today we're all going to the BBC to have some chats. And then I'm going to see Abigail and Megan. I think I'm also going to try and pop into Juicy today. I'm pure choking to try their tuna caddo flatbread thing. It's basically Jonah juice, so I want to try that. And then what else tonight, my mum and dad wants dinner with me tonight, because everybody was offered plus ones for the show premiere tomorrow, but as you can probably imagine, my mum and dad probably don't want to watch me break my heart on telly when they watched it actually happen. And my dad is very, very sensitive with me. So my dad was like, I just don't think I could sit there and watch you crumble, because that is basically what happens. When my dad was like, it was hard enough watching it in person, which I get. So my dad was like, me and your mum, my dad is also night shift, but he could have took it off. But I was just like, I even felt more comfortable with them not being there. Because I think on top of me feeling on edge, and at the premiere, we do watch this with like everyone's friends and family and like the head people from the BBC. So I think even myself, I felt like I would be so on edge knowing people are watching this happen, on top of trying to make sure mum and dad feel comfortable. And I know after that, I'd want my mum and dad to feel uncomfortable if people were bringing it up or whatever. So they're giving it a miss tomorrow. So tonight my dad was like, let's have a wee dinner. So I get a Nakadar, because he randomly phoned me last night, like, what's a good Indian? And I came in last night and I was like, oh, what Indian did you get? And he was like, oh, I meant for tomorrow for us. So we're getting a Nakadar tonight. And then tomorrow is the premiere. So I'm getting my hair and my makeup done tomorrow. I need to try on my outfits. I've ordered a few, but I just don't really love them. I need to put tan on. I scrubbed all my tan off. And then tomorrow will be the premiere. And then I'm staying in Megano. So that's super nice.
Took my blow dry out. It's giving fullness. I love it. Guys, my dad got me this from Rituals. He's like the biggest Rituals fan. It's like a little car air freshener. I can't go there because my hazard. But I'm just on 0 mile. Fucking story of my life is on being on 0 mile. So I'm just gonna quickly go to Morrison's, get some petrol, and then go and pick up Abigail, and then me, Megan, oh, wee bit of skidding. Me, Megan and Abigail are going for a juicy. So looking forward to it. But yeah, got myself all glam. Don't know why, because I'll probably fucking cry watching this, but here we are. Sometimes wearing makeup, this is such a girl thing, like wearing makeup like prevents you from crying because you obviously don't want to ruin it. And you do that pure ugly, like now you're like, oh my god, you try and catch your tears. Do that all fucking time. I went for short nails when I came back from Dubai. My long ones were just too long. I had long nails for quite a while there because it was like the festive time. I know that way I was like, oh, I'm bored of you. Like, I want like wee short, like I can like do that and it not be sore. And also because you could have let me go. Oh, busy morning, guys. I have filmed.
Hi. Hi. Hi, gorgeous girl. Where's my gorgeous Coco Loco? Oh, this is you. This is most gorgeous we go. This is most gorgeous we go. Give everyone kisses. See, I love you, everyone. Love you. Oh, you need a haircut. You need a wee haircut, hen. I love you.
Yeah, I've had such a productive morning, may I say. What did I do this morning? I've been up, got up at 6 this morning. Went to Sin at what's called Sin, it's like training basically. So because I don't think I trained with Dale last year, so no, it would have been a couple of years ago. I used to train with Dale in Commando. He still works there, but him and a boy, Ryan, now have Sin training, which is like classes, but it's like more intimate, like it's kind of like personal training, I would say. So I rejoined that because I'm now going to do that twice a week, along with I do PT with the girls twice a week. So that's going to be like my weight training. and then I'll just do spin or walking, like occasionally in between that. But I went last Friday for the first day, and then I went today because my days are, I go twice a week. I think my Botox has kicked in a bit too much for my liking. But it was really good this morning. So yeah, I've been up early, then I came home, had a few calls, had a press call with, I'm not actually sure who that was with this morning, from a show coming out. And then had chats at BBC this morning, and then I filmed two jobs. My hair's kind of fell flat, so I am going to redo my hair, and then I'm going to film a job for Boohoo, which I might show you a little bit of. I got two new tracksuits from Boohoo, and I absolutely love them. So I'm going to style them, and then I'm going to tidy this room, because it's a riot, and I'm going to edit the vlog that I want up tonight, and then I am... Yeah, I'm just going to have a date in the house today. I'm not really going anywhere. After the gym this morning, I went to a food shop, so... because I've ate all my HelloFresh meals. Raging, to be honest. Raging. But yeah, I went and bought stuff just to have dinners this week. And I'm seeing Jade tomorrow. Really excited. I've got one of those oil spots starting here, but I've not touched it. And it's actually not came in massive. So hallelujah. But I'm going to quickly do my hair, and then I'll show you my wee Boohoo tracksuits. Excuse the mess, guys, because this room's... I've been filming all day, but how nice is this wee tracksuit? I got it in grey marl as well, but I pure feel like this berry colour is so in at the moment. Even though I look by Christmas, I still feel like it's like such an in colour. But it's so comfy. I feel like if you're going on holiday, it's perfect because it's a wee bit smarter because it's not like a normal zipper with a hood. It's kind of like a bomber jacket zipper. But it's so comfy. So nice, I'm loving it. I'm going to just keep it on now. I'm actually really comfy in this wee outfit. But I want to get my hair up. My hair's doing mid tits today. It's too soft. That's the issue with my hair. It's too soft. Up it goes. Now I'm going to go and look at all this content and sit and edit it all together. Got a lot done on my phone today. So buzzing, and it's only 10 to 4. So it's actually quite good because I've now got time. I now just need to get this across to the Aquarius girls before they finish up for the day. But also, guys, see if you're looking for just like an instant tan. This one's really good. Loving Tan. It's actually what I've got on my body at the moment. This kind of nice tan colour. It's lovely. I really recommend it if you're looking for an instant tan. And it washes off nice. It's not too dark either. So, yeah.